Hi, welcome to today's short video where we're going to be looking at a subject that comes up a lot in CIMA E2 and CIMA E3 and of course in the wider business world. And this subject is SWOT. So what does SWOT stand for? Swatting a fly? SWOT team? Or does it actually stand for strengths, weaknesses, opportunities and threats? Well, you're about to find out because that's exactly what we're going to be looking at in today's video. We're going to be finding out all about SWOT analysis. So let's go back to the initial question. What exactly is SWOT analysis? Well, it's a way to analyze the business that we were just talking about, a way to find our strengths and a way to find our weaknesses. It also can be used as a way to find potential threats that we wouldn't necessarily have found unless we'd done this corporate appraisal, and we wouldn't have found until we were much later into a process. And as well, we can also use a SWOT analysis not only on ourselves, but also on competitors. And by doing one on ourselves and our competitors, where we can see where we differ, or we could see where there's an opportunity for our business to differ from the competitors. So it gives us a real advantage and a way that we can compete. So let's have a look at what SWOT analysis stands for. And I think we've mentioned a couple of terms already, so I don't think you're going to be surprised to find that the first S stands for strengths. And I also don't think you're going to be very surprised to find out the strengths are looking at the positives of the business. What are we good at? Now, it's important to realize that these strengths are strengths about the business. So this is about internally, what are we good at? And how can we use these strengths to our advantage? Now, if we stick with our example of pounds and pennies, it turns out that actually we've got a really great staff. They're really motivated, they're really passionate, they're really hardworking, they're really knowledgeable. And what this does, it means that actually, hold on a minute, we think, well, we've got this great staff that we can rely on. So what could we use that for? Maybe we could expand quicker than we thought we could have, because actually we've got all this staff in place. But can you see, we've taken the strength and we're using it, we're taking it forward. How can we use this strength in the future to achieve the goals that we set forward in the first stage of the rational planning model? But as I said, we've had strengths and we also must have weaknesses. Now it's really important to find out the weaknesses. And again, similar to strengths, these are internal. What are the weaknesses of our business? What are we not doing well? What happens if we continue to do these things not very well and we go forward on our plan? Is it going to stop us achieving our objectives and our goals? Now we've seen pounds and pennies, our financial team, we've got a great staff, but we do have a weakness. And that's our old computer system. And this old computer system really belongs in the last century. And in fact, even though our team is great, they're far less productive because they're using such an old IT system. If we improved our IT system, we'd be able to produce quickly, we'd be much more accurate, and we bring ourselves up to a level of our competitors. So what we've worked out by looking at this weakness is actually we really need to invest in a new computer system. But can you see, this is something that we were going along with okay at the moment, but if we're going to progress our plans, the fact that we weren't as quick or as accurate as our competitors would really stifle our chances of becoming the market leader. Okay, so we've got strengths and weaknesses. These are both internal to the business. We now move over to the O, which stands for opportunities. And with opportunities, we're looking at our future and external factors. So we're moving away from internally looking at the business and moving outwards to look more at the environment. Because you remember, on the rational planning model, we had the internal analysis and the environmental analysis pointing in at corporate appraisal. We're taking advantage of both of the analysis that we've already done. And it's vital to recognize the opportunity that lie in the external environment. Now, I don't know if you've heard of a software company called Microsoft. They're pretty big. And in the 1970s, you wouldn't have heard of them. And in fact, you'd been far more likely to have heard of the hardware tech giant IBM. But IBM didn't recognize the opportunity of software. Microsoft did. And within about 10 or 20 years, they became one of the biggest companies in the entire world. And IBM lost a significant portion of their market share. And this was all about spotting the opportunities in the external environment. So, for pounds and pennies, what kind of opportunities do you think they might see? Well, staying with our example, actually, the government have just launched an initiative, and there's going to be an upcoming tax break on small businesses. Now, this means that at pounds and pennies, we're going to be able to hire more staff, which means we'll be able to expand quicker. And obviously, taking into account our new computer system, we'll be as we're a larger company that's really competitive and accurate. But the important thing is we're aware of the opportunities so we can take advantage of them. So that's opportunities. We're staying with the external environment. So much like there was a positive and negative of the internal business in SWOT analysis, we're kind of seeing, aren't we, a positive and negative here, because opportunities are positive, aren't they? We want to take advantage of them because they're going to be really good for the company. But uh-oh, there's a negative as well, because of course the external environment also contains threats. And of course these threats, these external factors are going to have a negative impact on our business. And so it's really important that we also spot these threats, just like we spot opportunities, so we can avoid them to the best of our ability. So let's imagine for pounds and pennies that we've gone back to 2007, which is obviously a significant year for the world economy. Now we've got an opportunity to buy 10,000 derivatives, and these are repackaged debt instruments. Now we buy them for a bank, and we can sell them on to our investor clients for a nice little profit. Now, seemingly, this is going to bring a really good monthly income for our investors in the shape of interest payments. But we delve a little deeper, we do our due diligence, of course we do, and we learn the original loans are actually subprime mortgages. And these subprime mortgages are loans that were sold to high-risk, low-income borrowers. So, of course, the opportunity for those borrowers to default becomes much higher. And this would mean our clients end up short-changed, and eventually, because we wouldn't have spotted the threat, could have sued us. So instead, we decide to avoid this investment. We leave the toxic subprime debt with the bank, and we move on. We've spotted the threat, we've analyzed it, and we've avoided it. If we hadn't spotted that threat, our investors would have lost money, and we could have been sued. So there we go. That's SWOT analysis, looking at the internal and the external environment of an organization, looking for the strengths and weaknesses, and looking for the opportunities and threats. So there we go. A nice short video on SWOT, something that I hope you'll find really useful for your CIMA E2 and E3 exam specifically, but hopefully you'll find it useful later on in your career too. Now, if you're interested in watching more of these short SEMA related videos, then make sure you subscribe to this channel. Thank you very much.